Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you a quick and easy technique to create stunning black and white double exposure portraits. This is an update of tutorials I've done on earlier versions of Photoshop. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to my channel, click that small subscribe button at the lower right corner to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Open a color or black and white photo of someone in which one half of the face is in shadow. It can be a profile or face forward. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. If it's a black and white image, go to Image, Mode, and click RGB Color and 8 bits per channel. Open your Crop tool and your list of crop presets. Click Width, Height, and Resolution and clear the width and height. I'll make its resolution 150 pixels per inch. Go to each side of the bounding box and drag them in until your image is sized and positioned to accommodate the second photo that you'll be using for the double exposure. Then press Enter or Return or click the check mark at the top. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0 or press Ctrl or Command and the plus sign to zoom it in incrementally. Next, we'll brush in black outside the area of your subject that's in shadow. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Brush tool and make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively. If they're not, press D on your keyboard. Open your Brush Picker and pick a soft, round brush. We'll adjust its size in a moment. Make its hardness 0% and the opacity and flow 100%. To make your brush bigger or smaller, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Then brush outside the area of your subject that's in shadow. Next, we'll make a selection that delineates your subject from its background. First, make your subject active. If the background is a solid color, as in this example, you can use the magic wand tool. However, if the background on your image is not a solid color, the quick selection tool is generally a good choice. If you are using the magic wand tool, make sure contiguous is checked to ensure that the inside of your subject won't be selected as well. Click anywhere on the background to make a selection of it. Open another photo that you'd like to use for the double exposure. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. To place it onto the subject, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of your subject. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. We'll adjust its size and position in a minute. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the other photo. Since we want to size and position the photo and not the layer mask, click off the chain link icon to unlink the layer and the layer mask. Doing this allows us to resize and position either of them independently of the other. Click the photo to make it active and change its blend mode to hard light. Click the adjustment layer icon and click black and white. Make the photo active and open your transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. If you're using version CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. To reposition it, go inside the Transform's bounding box and drag it. When the photo is sized and positioned to your liking inside your subject, press Enter or Return. To bring out the detail in the darkest areas, invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard or by clicking this icon. Open your Dodge tool. Open the Range list and click Midtones. The exposure is 100%. I'll make its size 500 pixels and its hardness 0%, but feel free to make it any size you like. Brush over the darkest areas to bring out their detail. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.